Many people are absolutely delusional about what body fat percentages really look like for women. The reason for this is that very few high-quality data are available. On social media, you commonly see these photos flying around with a bunch of physiques and body fat percentage labels attached to them, but these are often based on a complete guess by the author. They just got some stock photos together and put a number on that that seemed reasonable to that individual. Many people also do body fat percentage estimates via unreliable methods, like bioelectrical impedance scales and body fat percentage calipers. Those methods typically significantly underestimate the body fat percentage of women that have more muscle mass or are leaner than the average individual. So fit women typically get an estimate that's far below their actual body fat percentage estimate. Of course, people like to hear these things, so they go with it, and as a result, many people have a skewed perception of what body fat percentages actually look like. Fortunately for you, I've been working in fitness for over a decade, and in my time coaching and teaching people, I've amassed a lot of photos of women that had reliable estimates of their body fat percentage. Most of these are DEXA scans performed under standardized conditions with a calibrated scan suitable for that individual's body type. Most of these photos are for my clients or students, and I have explicit permission to use their photos. Some of the other photos were posted publicly. So without further ado, let's look at some of the photos. Here's a series of DEXA scans from Dr. Natalia Spearings, who turned IFBB Pro after this. So all the way on the left, we have her at 39% body fat, which is overweight or obese by most standards even. She carries it very well, she has a very even body fat distribution, so most people wouldn't look this good at 39% body fat. Then in the middle, we have her at 25%, and all the way on the right, where she's absolutely shredded, we have her at 14% body fat, closing in on 13. 13 seems high to many people, but it's actually the upper end of essential body fat levels. There's very little subcutaneous fat left at that point. Most of the fat is around the organs, in the central nervous system, in the boobs. So it's very, very difficult for women to get below 13% body fat. When you hear of these people saying like, oh yeah, I was 5% body fat at that time, unless they're speaking to you from the afterlife, that is probably incorrect. Here we have two more bikini competitors at 17% body fat. On the left and the right, you can see that they are already very lean, typically very little cellulite left at this point. Abdominal definition is there, even though women typically don't get a full six-pack. Depends a lot on how much muscle mass you have. For men, it's much easier to get a full six-pack than for women. You typically get more something like this, unless you actively train the abs a lot. But it's clear that there are no more love handles and very little fat left, objectively speaking. Many women can compete in bikini shows around 17% body fat or a little bit lower. Here we have one of my students at 22% body fat versus 17% on the right. So you can see that the difference is not massive, but at 22% body fat, she's already very lean. The difference is that at 17% body fat, she has abdominal definition visible even when not flexing. There are essentially no more love handles left, and she looks very lean even without any posing. Moving up a little in body fat percentage, here we have 21% body fat, which is again still very lean, no significant love handles, no gut. For many women, 21% body fat is essentially bikini model level. Here we have a comparison of 20 versus 18% body fat using hydrostatic weighing, very similar to the previous photos. Moving up a little bit, we have 23% body fat according to InBody here. You can see that there are still no protruding body fat stores, but they are looking more thick. Moving up to 25% body fat, 25% is still a very lean, good, healthy body fat percentage for women. More examples of 25% body fat, again, very lean, aspirational for many women. 26% body fat, we are starting to see a little bit of love handles. Another example of 26% body fat, and here we have an example of 27% body fat versus that same individual at 16% body fat. At 16% body fat, if she had more muscle mass, she would be competitive in physique shows. 27% body fat is still not fat by any means, but you start to see more love handles and indentations around the clothing. Here we have 32% body fat, and then moving up to 37% body fat. When you pass 33% body fat, by most standards, that is technically overweight. So here we are looking at overweight body fat percentages. And when you pass 39% body fat, that is technically obese by most standards. Like here, we have an example of 44% body fat. And here we have a compilation photo of some of these photos together, as you see on social media, but here based on actual laboratory-grade body fat percentage estimates of real individuals, and from the back as well. Now it should be noted that DEXA scans, even when they are performed under standardized conditions, which is usually fasted in the morning, using a properly calibrated scan, are still not perfectly accurate. It's very common for DEXA scans to be a few percentage points off. Moreover, you don't see the entire physiques of the individuals in the photos, and people differ substantially in how they store their body fat. Some women have a very feminine body fat distribution, they get more of a Brazilian type body, with most of the fat around the hips, the legs, the lower body, the typical pear shape, whereas other women have a more centralized body fat storage pattern. So depending on which part of the body you look at, you would get a slightly distorted view of someone's actual body fat percentage. Nevertheless, I hope these photos help give you a more realistic, objective view of what body fat percentages actually look like in women, as well as what thresholds are associated with being overweight and obese. If you like this type of evidence-based content, I'd be honored if you like and subscribe. And if you're a serious strength trainee that wants to know everything there is about losing fat, building muscle, and being healthy, check out my online course. The link is in the description.